Hello wonderful people, my name is Olubunmi. Welcome back to my channel. So today I want to share an exciting party cooking. Yeah, we made some party cooking over the weekend and I'm going to show you how I made some cookings. Not every food, but some of it. So at the party, it was the 50th birthday party for a wonderful person. So we made some food, some snacks, and I met an amazing man that showed me how to make Jamaica something. I've forgotten, but don't worry, I'm gonna get those recipe. I'll do a separate video on that. So we are able to make some puff puffs, some buns. So guys, not to worry, I'm going to show you how to make a party puff puff, party buns, and how to season your party chicken and turkey. So let's start right away. So I'll just show you how I made my chicken for the party. So now I'm just kind of rinsing it, you know, it's just I was so overwhelmed. So these are the seasonings I use to marinate the chicken. I use my onions. I put the chicken seasoning inside, so I give it a blend together because I want a paste, like a smooth paste. I do not want to start slicing the onions. I want everything to be smooth and well blended. So that was why I'm doing all that now. So I finished blending it inside my big pot. Can you see that pot? It's so big. So I've already rinsed the chicken, as I've showed you earlier. So I'm going to bring in the blended seasonings and I'll put everything inside there and mix it. So you know, all the seasoning is not finished, so I added more. I add curry to it, add thyme, salt, and I added 3 chili pepper to it. So if you do not want to blend your seasoning the way I did, you can just go ahead and give your onions a good slice, make it finely sliced, and add it to it. Put your chicken seasonings, but I just want everything to be blended together because it's party and there's no lot of time, there's no luxury time to do that. So I just have to blend everything together and it makes my work easier. So I just added a little bit of chicken seasoning there. So now it's time to mix it together. So I mix it together and I left it, I covered it and leave it for like 1 hour before I started boiling it. Though I didn't film when I was boiling it because trust me, it was a whole lot of work. So I did my turkey the same way, same seasoning, same quantity. That's what I used. So I'm just mixing the turkey together again and I left it for 1 hour again. Then I gave it a good boil, but because I want to grill it, I didn't allow it to be fully boiled, as in cooked, while boiling it. So I grill it. But if you do not have time for grilling, or maybe you're in a hurry or rushing, just give it a good boil, make it to be well cooked, then fry it. I think frying is more faster, but I have the time for grilling. Actually, I prefer to grill my chicken because I notice their chicken and their turkey here is kind of too fatty, and I do not want to add to the fat. Do you understand what I'm saying? So I just try to boil it and grill it to remove the fat. So here it is. After boiling it, I have this. So I have laid in my tray, about to go inside the oven. But before then, I just use olive oil to coat it so that it won't get dried. So I coat it with some olive oil to avoid dryness. And I place it over my oven and I keep checking. Then after I bring it out, I prepare the sauce, the pepper sauce, to mix the chicken and the turkey with. So I didn't film how I started, but it's just normal sauce, it's nothing serious. It's just my tomato sauce that I've made, and I make sure there is a little bit of chili pepper, not too much because I do not want it to be too spicy, because it is party. Chicken and turkey is not for personal use, and it's not everybody that loves to take pepper, so I just make it a little bit. It didn't even show that it was spicy, actually. Just do your thing. So I placed it inside the oven and I left it there. I think I did it. I did 4 trays for each chicken and the turkey. I did 4 trays because it was actually much. So, and after this batch, I went ahead and do another batch. So, and that was it for the grilling. And this is the turkey. Yeah, this is it for the turkey. I did for the chicken. This for the turkey. So inside this place, I've already prepared the sauce. This is my chicken here, doing its thing. So inside an empty pot, all you have to do is put your vegetable oil and slice onions and add onions to heat. So I added my seasonings inside it, curry, thyme, salt, a little bit of salt to taste, because you're gonna use the stock water, so do not add too much of salt. So I had that, and I had my bay leaf just to give it that taste scent. And then I just add the chicken inside and mix everything together to allow it to incorporate with the sauce. So I mix it, and after some minutes I bring it out. So I'm doing the same thing for the second batch, and all over and over and over again till I finish for the chicken and the turkey. And this is the turkey that I'm doing now, and that was how I did it. So don't worry, I'll do a video, a proper video on how I actually achieve the sauce, but that is it. This is the end result. If you do not want to make it a pepper chicken or pepper turkey, yeah, after frying your chicken or turkey, just go ahead and serve it at the party like that. So here I want to mix my dough for the buns. I wouldn't be able to do the full video how I make it, but I'll, in my separate video, I'm going to upload it during the week on how I make my patty buns, how I achieve it, and how I make my patty puff puff. So this is just to show you some things I did. I didn't even, so many videos didn't even come here because I would take a lot of time, and I just want to show you what I did over the weekend, just in a summary. That is why I'm kind of fast forwarding it. I'm just mixing my dough for buns, and it was pretty good, and that was it. So I mix it. I just left it for like 20 minutes. I put my hot oil on in the pan and I fried it, and trust me, the taste was so good. It tastes so good, it tastes so yummy. And this is me mixing my puff puff. That's my son's leg. Yeah, you always want to see what I'm doing. So I'm mixing my puff puff here. I had my vanilla flavor. I like it inside my snacks, I don't know why. So, and here it is. I left it for 2 hours. There was no time for overnight. I fried it, and voila. Yeah, tastes good as, yeah. So now I just kind of bring it out, and this is me. So the puff puff came out so nice, so pretty. This is our buns, the puff puff, and we had 2 trays of puff puff and 1 tray of buns. And at the party, we made some intestine pepper soup with fish pepper soup. This is the intestine pepper soup here. It was so nice, it was so yummy. The party was so good, we had fun. So this is the amazing man that taught me, that showed me how to make this drink. And I couldn't show his face. Yeah, so sorry about that, but these are the drinks. The drinks taste so good. So we use spicy ginger beer and mint leaf, of course, lime, ice cubes, and that is apotin. That is protein. So we had some apotin, and it was so good. It tastes so good. Mix everything together and enjoy, you know. It is so fun, and that is it there. We're trying to mix everything together so it to have a good taste. Just trying to add more ice cubes there, But I'm going to get the whole recipe again and make it in a separate video and post it. So this is it. See how pretty they are. So we're just trying to make another big jar, just the same drink. So that is the ice, the mint leaf is down there. I'm just trying to take the tulip away. So that's the spicy ginger beer. We put like 3 bottles in this big jar, 3 bottles of ginger beer. Yeah, it's called spicy ginger beer. 3 bottles of it, and after that we mix everything together and we had a happening and lime. You can use lemon actually, but this is lime. We use lime here. And that was it for the drink. We have a lot of drinks, but this one is kind of special because before you know it, it was already finished. People really enjoyed it. So, and that was it for the drink. And now guys, are you still watching? Please subscribe to my channel. Please like and click the notification bell so that you can get alert when I post new videos. Thank you. So let's continue. So there's nothing much again, so just kind of mixing everything together with the lime and place it inside the refrigerator. And that's the apple tea we're having now. Apple tea rum, yeah, that's the name. So he actually mentioned a name of another drink to add, but I will confirm from him. I don't know if I will, yeah, I'll confirm and make a proper video on how to do this drink later, and I'll post it. Yeah, so this is it. The weekend was so fun, and yeah, I was just for the party. Thank you guys, to have a great day. Bye for now.